Hey guys, and welcome to today's video. Now I'm guessing if you clicked on this video, you're wondering what on earth those fuzzy little worms are in your feeder insect tubs. Now I was the same many moons ago when I started buying feeder insects, so I thought I would share with you today what on earth these actually are. Now these worms are in fact Dermestid beetle larvae. I hope I pronounced that right. Now that probably doesn't clear things up too much. You're probably still wondering, are they safe? Will they harm my feeder insects? And can my reptiles eat them? So, to answer your first question, yes, they are safe. They're actually often put amongst insect colonies as part of the cleanup crew. They will eat the molted skin or exoskeleton of the insect. They actually eat dead insects. They eat their poop. They will eat leftover decaying food or plant matter. They're actually a really big help in keeping colonies nice and clean. And thankfully, they won't compete with your colony for food. There is just one other thing you should probably know about them. They're known for eating flesh. Yeah, like actual flesh. People will use them when they're doing taxidermy and they want to get the skin off of the bones without damaging the skeleton. Because I found this out because I found this frequently asked question, which, without knowing what this was used for, you're kind of like, okay, who is asking how many of these do you need to clean a skull? That is very worrying. But yes, this is something they actually do. Now, as I said, the worms are just a larvae. They will eventually pupate and turn into beetles. The beetles are also really good at removing flesh. They also can fly, but like not amazingly. I have heard that if you remove all their food and water, they can get the ability to fly quite well. So obviously, if you're keeping them, make sure there's a lid on them just in case. They're not usually this white. I just happened to be filming them in a tub that also had some vitamin powder in, and they covered themselves in it. Before turning into beetles, they do molt about 7 to 9 times, and here you can see an example of their molt. After 5 to 6 weeks, they will pupate, and after about a week or so, they'll emerge as a beetle. They only probably live about 4 to 5 months, and females tend to be bigger than males. Now, the whole cycle can actually be a lot quicker in the wild when they're literally feasting on a carcass. Some of this can happen in a matter of weeks from egg to beetle, but in captivity, as we are keeping them right now, this is sort of the time frame you're looking at. Now, I usually only get 5 to 10 of these worms at the most when I get crickets. And when I'm done with the crickets, I'll either honestly just throw the worms in the bin, because the bin probably has meat and stuff in there that they will happily break down, or I might put them in a compost heap. But it does seem that this time round, I have a ton of these worms. I don't know if it's the substrate they're in. I have some wood shavings here, or my crickets came with beetles that bred and those eggs hatched out very quickly, and now I have a small infestation. Now personally, I'm not really sure what to do with them. As I said, I don't usually have many, so 1 or 2 in a bin isn't too bad, but these seem quite useful. So I could put some in with my mealworm breeding colony. I know a lot of people use these with roaches. So if you are breeding feeder insects and cleaning them out, it's taking ages, they smell, you need something, maybe you'll want some of these worms or beetles. Keep them aside and they could become very handy. Now, I have read that reptiles can eat these, though their nutritional value isn't very well known. Most insectivores, though, are opportunistic hunters and will most certainly eat a range of beetles and their larvae in the wild. So if your gecko happens to accidentally eat one of these, it's not the end of the world. It will be fine. Would I recommend these as a staple diet? No, because I don't know how healthy these are, but 1 or 2 here and there isn't going to do anything too bad. Now, some people will also use these as a cleanup crew in their arid tanks. Now, mine at the moment live at the bottom of an empty cricket tank in wood shavings. So as you can see, this is pretty dry. So it does seem like they'd probably do fine in a drier tank. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to introduce them into my leopard gecko tank straight away. I think I'd prefer to do a little bit more research beforehand, but there is some potential. I will leave some interesting articles and videos about these beetles below so you can find out a little more about them. Since I have such a big colony this time around, I may even do a time lapse of them breaking down like some meat or something. Random cutaway, I decided to offer these worms some meat,
some cooked ham. I'm sure they prefer raw. But I thought I'd film a time lapse, and the time lapse happened to go on for about 3 hours. That's not enough time for them to fully eat this ham, but as you can see, in those like 2 or 3 hours, like, they've left their mark. I'm gonna probably just leave it in there, but my goodness. But yeah, my phone was about to die, so I had to stop the time lapse, but I hope you enjoyed that random time lapse.
Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you leave a like and let me know, have you ever got these worms with your feeder insects, and what did you do with them? Anyway, I hope you liked this video. Thank you for watching and goodbye.